وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى in today's episode I want to speak about the meaning of لا إله إلا الله. What does لا إله إلا الله mean? كلمة التوحيد. My beloved brothers and sisters, we've already taken the virtue of this word. We mentioned that it is خير الذكر, it is the best word to say. It is the most virtuous word to say. It is the best reminder. It is the completest. But it won't be accepted to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala by just merely saying it. The person has to what? Stand up in learning the meaning of La ilaha illallah, in understanding it, in applying the real meaning that it has, which is negating partnership with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and singling Him subhanahu wa ta'ala in His rights. You don't associate partners with Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in His rights in no way, shape or form, and you single Him in it subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is also to have that i'tiqad, jazim, that you believe it deep in your heart what la ilaha illallah means. Act upon it, then you're going to be a real Muslim. And then you're going to be from what? Min ahli la ilaha illallah. You'll be from the people of la ilaha illallah. So let's go through its meaning. So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala can make us from the people of la ilaha illallah. Because the greatest oppression and the greatest misguidance is to associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says in the Qur'an, وَمَنْ أَضَلُّ مِمَّنْ يَدْعُو مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مَنْ لَا يَسْتَجِيبُ لَهُ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ وَهُمْ عَنْ دُعَائِهِمْ غَافِلُونَ وَإِذَا حُشِرَ النَّاسُ كَانُوا لَهُمْ أَعْدَاءً وَكَانُوا بِعِبَادَتِهِمْ كَافِرِينَ. Allah says, وَمَنْ أَضَلُّ, who is more misguided than who? مِمَّنْ يَدْعُو مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ, the one who calls on to other than Allah. Besides Allah, he calls on to someone else. مَنْ لَا يَسْتَجِيبُ لَهُ, he calls on to someone or something that will not accept his dua. إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ وَهُمْ عَنْ دُعَائِهِمْ غَافِلُونَ. You're calling on to one or individual who's heedless about your supplication and your dua. وَإِذَا حُشِرَ النَّاسُ كَانُوا لَهُمْ أَعْدَاءً وَكَانُوا بِعِبَادَتِهِمْ كَافِرِينَ. And these people that you're worshipping, وَإِذَا حُشِّرَ النَّاسُ كَانُوا لَهُمْ أَعْدَاءً, these creation that you're calling on to besides Allah, if they are gathered and they're resurrected يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ, they are going to be your enemies. And at the end, look what Allah says, وَكَانُوا بِعِبَادَتِهِمْ كَافِرِينَ. Allah referred to it as a what? عِبَادَةً. And they are going to be disbelievers of the ibadah that you did to them. They will be ungrateful to the ibadah that you did for them. They will disregard the ibadah that you did for them. But that was because you called on to them. Besides Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, and Allah referred to it as a ibadah. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He tells us, ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقُّ وَأَنَّ مَا يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِهِ هُوَ الْبَاطِلِ وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْكَبِيرُ. Allah says, ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ, that is because Allah tabarak wa ta'ala huwa al-haq, Allah is the one that is haq. Then Allah is telling us here that He is haq. There are ilahs other than Allah, but they are not haq. They're batil. But the ilah that is haq is Allah tabarak wa ta'ala only. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقَّ وَأَنَّمَا يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِهِ هُوَ الْبَاطِلِ. And everything that they are worshipping besides Allah تبارك وتعالى are باطل. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْكَبِيرُ. Also Allah تبارك وتعالى, he says, إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. Verily shirk is the greatest oppression. The greatest crime a human being can commit is shirk. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he says, وَالْكَافِرُونَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. The disbelievers are ظالمون. They are oppressors. They are criminals. Why? Because what is ظلم? What is oppression? Oppression means, brothers, هُوَ وَضْعُ الشَّيْءِ فِي غَيْرِ مَوْضِعِ. It is to place something in a place other than its place. It is to put something in other than its place. That's what dhulm means. Dhulm means you're taking someone's right and you're giving it to someone else. Or you're taking someone's right and you're giving it to yourself. That's the essence of oppression. That is what dhulm means. Allah's haqq, Allah's right, you're taking away from him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you're giving it to who? You're giving it to someone else. That's the greater dhulm a person can come with. صرف العبادة لغير الله, diverting ibadah for other than Allah is what? ظلمٌ, it's oppression. Because you're placing the right of Allah, which is ibadah, you're giving it to someone else. Rather, it is what? أظلمُ الظلمِ وأخطرُه. It is the greatest form of oppression. It is the greatest crime and atrocity a person can commit. And the most dangerous of it is to do ظلم. إذن لا إله إلا الله, my beloved brothers and sisters, is كلمة عظيمة. It's a very powerful word. And we have to understand what it means. It is necessary, brothers and sisters, لابد من ضبطه. We have to be precise in what it means. Because by unanimous agreement of the scholars, it is not beneficial for you, لا إله إلا الله. By unanimous agreement of the ulama, just by merely pronouncing this word, من غير فهم لمعناها, without actually understanding its meaning and not acting upon what it entails. Allah says in the Quran, ولا يملك الذين يدعون من دون الشفاعة إلا من شهد بالحق وهم يعلمون. Allah تبارك وتعالى, he says, ولا يملك الذين, they do not own, they don't have power and strength. Who? الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِهِ. Those who are calling besides Allah تبارك وتعالى, مِن دُونِهِ الشَّفَاعَةِ, intercession. إِلَّا مَن شَهِدَ بِالْحَقِّ, except the one who testifies with haqq. And we already mentioned what it means, إِلَّا مَن شَهِدَ بِالْحَقِّ, it means, إِلَّا مَن شَهِدَ بِلَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ بِقُلُوبِهِمْ, whilst they know it in their hearts. يعني they pronounce لا إله إلا الله with their tongues, and their hearts are in يعني, knowledge of it. They know what it means. They're not just saying this word. إِلَّا مَنْ شَهِدَ بِلَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. That's what it means. وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ, they have knowledge of it. In their hearts, they know what it means. They know مَعْنَى لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ and the meaning that it holds. That is what Allah mentioned in the ayah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what does it mean, brothers and sisters? لا إله إلا الله, it means we have the word لا, which is a negation. We're negating what? لا إله. We're negating ألوهية. We're negating ألوهية. So the question here is, what does the word إله mean in the Arabic language? The word الإله in the Arabic language, it means المعبود. مألوه إله, مألوه أي معبود. إله is al-ma'bud, is the one that's worshipped. So when you say la ilah, we said ilah means what? Ma'bud. So when you translate, when you explain that to be, when you look at the kalimatu tawhid, you say la ilaha ay la, we said ilah means ma'bud, right? So we say la ma'buda illallah. There is none worshipped. Again, the word haqq is brought from the ayah, ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ هو الحق, because there are ma'buds, there are ones who are worshipped. You can't negate that. There are existing ma'buds that are worshipped. They are batil, and Allah is haq. And that's why you bring that word haq from the verse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You say, لا معبود حق إلا الله. That there is nothing that is worshipped with truth, with haq, except Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Allah is the only one who deserves it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of these idols and all of those ilahs that are worshipped, they are batil, as the ayah mentions, ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقِّ وَأَنَّ مَا يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِهِ هُوَ الْبَاطِلِ. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He told us that the word ilah, it means ma'bud. In the Qur'an, Allah says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِن قَبْلِكَ مِن رَسُولٍ إِلَّا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِ أَنَّهُ إلا نوحي إليه أنه لا إله إلا أنا فاعبدون. Allah says, وما أرسلنا, I have not sent من قبلك before you Muhammad من رسول, a messenger, إلا نوحي, except the revelation that we sent on that prophet or that messenger is what? أنه لا إله, that there is no إله, إلا أنا, except me, فاعبدوني, worship me. Allah is saying what? Worship me, subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا إله, it means معبود, based on the ayah, where Allah says, إلا أنا فاعبدون, worship me, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا. Allah says, I have sent down في كل أمة, every nation I sent, Allah is saying, رسولا, a messenger. What was the messenger according to? أن اعبدوا الله واجتنبوا الطاغوت. Worship Allah. And then the thing that prophet was calling his people to is what? أن اعبدوا الله, worship Allah, واجتنبوا الطاغوت, and stay away from everything that is worship besides Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So the thing that the Prophet was calling to what? And that messenger was calling his people to is, an i'budu Allah, worship Allah, which is ithbat, affirming it for Allah. Wajitaribu al-taghut, which is nafyun, negation. And you're not worshipping anything besides Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Then what we just learned from there is, the word ilah means al-ma'bud. That's what we took from the two verses. So la ilaha illallah, what does it mean, brothers and sisters? It means ikhlasul ibadati lillahi wahda. It is to single Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, worship for Him alone. And it is to stay away from what? Ibadati al-tawuti, worshiping the tawagheed. ولذلك, in the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to Quraysh, he spoke to them, alayhi salatu wasalam, he said to them, قولوا la ilaha illallah, go and say la ilaha illallah. And they responded and they said, أَجَعَلَ الْآلِهَةَ إِلَهًا وَاحِدًا إِنَّ هَذَا لَشَيْءٌ عُجَابٌ. They said, أَجَعَلَ الْآلِهَةَ, has He made the ilahs into what? إِلَهًا وَاحِدًا, only into one? يعني we have all, they all had different tribes, had their different ilahs, into different ilahs. So they say, Muhammad, is he trying to tell us that the ilahs are only one? There's only one ilah? Inna hadha la shay'un ujab. That's a fascinating thing. So Quraysh understood that la ilaha illallah means la ma'buda bihaqin illallah. Then all the ilahs are batil. All of the ilahs that are worshipped are batil. And that there's only one ilah that's haq. They say, is that what Muhammad wants us to believe now? Straight away they understood it. The nation of Hud, the people of Hud, Qawm Hud, they said to their prophet Hud alayhi salam, when he said to them, say la ilaha illallah, same thing. They responded and they said what? Aji'tana lina'abuda allaha wahda wa nadhara ma kana ya'budu aba'una. They said, have you come to us? They said to Hud alayhi salam. Why have you come to us? لِنَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ تَوَاشِبَ اللَّهِ. إذن إله means معبود, right? لِنَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ وَحْدَ. You have come to us to worship who? Allah. وَحْدَهَ alone. Is that what you're coming to us with? Are you trying to convince us that we should only worship Allah alone? وَنَذَرَ مَا كَانَ يَعْبُدُ آبَاؤُنَا. And we dismiss and ignore and forget and leave off that which our forefathers were worshipping. Is that what you really want? So they understood what he meant by say la ilaha illallah. They knew it wasn't just a mere word to say. They knew that a belief had to come with it. They knew, they understood what that meaning was. Because these are Arab, aqhah. They are Arabs who understand the language, who speak the language. As the poet said, لَسْتُ بِنَحْوِيٍّ يَلُوكُ لِسَانَهُ وَلَكِنِّي سَلِيقِيٌّ أَقُولُ فَأُعْرِبْ. He said, I'm not a grammarian per se. I haven't studied grammar like that. لَسْتُ بِنَحْوِيٍّ. I'm not a grammarian. يَلُوكُ لِسَانَهُ, where I have to observe my tongue. Is this مبتدا? Is this خبر? Okay, what is this one? Is a فعل? It's a فاعل. It's a مفعول الذي لم يسمى فاعله. This is ظرف. This was. I'm not a person who observes those things. I have to look at the grammatical structure and the جملة. Is it جملة اسمية فعلية? لست بنحوي. I am not a grammarian like that. But what I am is what? لست بنحوي يلوك لسان ولكني سليقي. I'm a سليقي, meaning I'm a natural born speaker. I speak and I know how to speak. I know this language as, I know it naturally. I didn't have to study in school or in a madrasa, or I didn't have to study in a circle. I'm a saliqi. This is natural for me. This is my mother tongue. أقول, I say what I want, فأعرب, and it automatically is grammatically right. As soon as it comes out of my mouth, it's grammatically right. There's nothing wrong with it. You listen to me, you're gonna be amazed with what comes out of my mouth. Grammatically correct. The structure is right. So this is what the people were. They understood the language of their prophets. They understood what that prophet was trying to say to them. لَسْتُ بِنَحْوِيٍّ يَلُوكُ لِسَانَهُ. So when Nabi Muhammad came to Quraysh and said, قُولُوا لَا إِلَىٰ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, say لَا إِلَىٰ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, they knew what he wanted from them. They knew that لَا إِلَهَ, إِلَهَ means ma'bud, and it doesn't mean خَالِق or رَازِق or مُدَبِّر or نَافِع or ضُر. They knew it didn't mean that. And that's not the meaning it holds, that it has a bigger meaning than that. So what they did was, they didn't want to accept it. They didn't want to accept that. And they wanted to reject it. وَلِذَلِكَ, because of that, brothers and sisters, since we took that la ilaha, ilah means ma'bud. Ilah means ma'bud. And then we said la ilaha illallah. La ma'buda. Haqqun, we have to bring. We mentioned where we got the haqq from. We mentioned that it's from the ayah where Allah says, ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقِّ. Because we mentioned that there are ilahs besides Allah that are worshipped. But are they haqq or they're batil? They are batil. They are batil. Okay? Because Allah told us in the Qur'an, and Allah referred to those which they worship besides Allah. Allah referred to it as a what? Allah referred to it as an ilah. In many places in the Qur'an, Allah says, فَمَا أَغْنَتْ عَنْهُمْ آلِهَتُهُمُ الَّتِي يَدْعُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. It hasn't benefited them, the ilahs that they worship besides Allah. Allah referred to it as. Allah is affirming for what they are worshipping as the ilah. But then what's the difference between that and Allah? Allah is haqq. That's batil. Okay? That is batil. So that's why we have to bring the word haqq in there. Because if you say la ma'buda illa Allah, it means that you're saying there's nothing worship besides Allah. And there is. Why was there even a discussion with Quraysh and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam if there is nothing that there was worship besides Allah? There is. There are things that are worship besides Allah. There are things that are taken as a ilah besides Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. But those things are batil. And the only thing that is haqq is who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By the way, brothers and sisters, this series is to simplify the matter. I'm not going too technical in the issue. I want to make it very easy for everybody to understand, to know how to worship their Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah make us subhanahu wa ta'ala bimannihi wa karamihi. May Allah make us from the people of la ilaha illallah. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala strip from us shirk and associating partners with him subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are many verses in the Qur'an that has come to clarify La ilaha illallah for us. And from those verses is قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى
وَإِلَاهُكُمْ إِلَاهٌ وَاحِدٌ لَا إِلَاهَ إِلَّا هُوَ الرَّحْمَنُ الرَّحِيمُ.
And the verse of Allah,
وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ حُنَفَاءَ.
And the verse of Allah,
وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ لِأَبِيهِ وَقَوْمِهِ إِنَّنِي بَرَاءٌ مِّمَّا تَعْبُدُونَ إِلَّا الَّذِي فَطَرَنِي فَإِنَّهُ سَيَهْدِينَ وَجَعَلَ كَلِمَةً بَاقِيَةً فِي عَقِبِهِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ.
Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala even mentioned when he was talking about the mu'min of Yasin, in Surah Yasin, when Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala said,
وَمَا لِيَ لَا أَعْبُدُ الَّذِي فَطَرَنِي وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ أَأَتَّخِذُ مِن دُونِهِ آلِهَةً إِن يُرِدْنِ الرَّحْمَنُ بِضُرٍّ لَا تُغْنِ عَنِّي شَفَاعَتُهُمْ شَيْئًا لَا تُغْنِ عَنِّي شَفَاعَتُهُمْ شَيْئًا وَلَا يُنْقِذُونَ إِنِّي إِذَا لَفِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ.
Also Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, he says,
قُلْ إِنِّي أُمِرْتُ أَنْ أَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصًا لَهُ الدِّينَ وَأُمِرْتُ لِأَنْ أَكُونَ أَوَّلَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ قُلْ إِنِّي أَخَافُ إِنْ عَصَيْتُ رَبِّي عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ قُلِ اللَّهَ أَعْبُدُ مُخْلِصًا لَهُ دِينِي.
Allah also mentioned about the story of who? Mu'min Ali Fir'aun. Qala Ta'ala, Allah says,
وَيَا قَوْمِ مَا لِي أَدْعُوكُمْ إِلَى النَّجَاةِ وَتَدْعُونَنِي إِلَى النَّارِ تَدْعُونَنِي لِأَكْفُرَ بِاللَّهِ وَأُشْرِكَ بِهِ مَا لَيْسَ لِي بِهِ عِلْمٍ وَأَنَا أَدْعُوكُمْ إِلَى الْعَزِيزِ الْغَفَّارِ لَا جَرَمَ أَنَّمَا تَدْعُونَنِي إِلَيْهِ لَيْسَ لَهُ دَعْوَةٌ فِي الدُّنْيَا لَيْسَ لَهُ دَعْوَةٌ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَلَا فِي الْآخِرَةِ وَأَنَّ مَرَدَّنَا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَأَنَّ الْمُسْرِفِينَ هُمْ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ.
The verses that talk about this, brothers and sisters, are many that clarify to us that the meaning of La ilaha illallah is what? It is to free yourself from al-bara'atu min ibadati ma siwa Allah. It is to free yourself from worshipping anything besides Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, min ash-shufa'i wal andadi wa ifradu Allah wahdahu bil ibadah. It is to free yourself from worshipping anything besides Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, whether it be intercessions, whether it be things that you make equal to Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, and it is to single Him Subhanahu wa Ta'ala in ibadah. That is guidance. That is what true beneficial knowledge is, brothers and sisters. That is the true religion, which is righteous action. That is what Allah sent messengers, subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is what Allah sent books for, this word, La ilaha illallah. In that meaning that we just explained, in that summarized basic meaning that I want every one of you to understand, inshaAllah ta'ala. La ilaha illallah, it means La ma'buda haqqun illallah. Dua
is a ibadah that you can't divert for other, you can't divert for anyone other than Allah. Dua is a ibadah that you cannot divert for anyone other than Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. It's a ibadah you only can do for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Khawf, it's a ibadah that you could only do for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And al-dhabhu, al-nadhar, all of these. And many other types of ibadat. You need to do all for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. La ilaha illallah is not just a mere name that has no meaning in it, or a speech that hasn't got a reality, or a word that doesn't have a meaning under it, as some people might think. La ilaha illallah has a meaning. And inshallah ta'ala, I hope inshallah in this episode I've given you a basic understanding of it. A basic understanding of it. If the future inshallah ta'ala Allah gives us strength and Allah gives us a long life, we'll be going through it in greater detail inshallah ta'ala and clarifying in great details bi'idhnillahi al-kareem. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, and shaytan and Allah and his messenger are both free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdi ashadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.